Hi guys, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl, Kinesthetic with the Kinesthetics, and I'm here with you guys today with a new video. So today's video is going to be a chit chat, get ready with me, and the topic of today's chit chat is going to be kind of a story time. It's gonna be all about my retail job experiences, and I'm so excited to speak about this because I don't think I've ever shared these things with you guys, so this will be something new, you know what I'm saying? So before we get started, make sure you guys subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit that red subscribe button down below. We on the road to 10k, so go ahead and join, because we're about to be doing lit thing. We already been doing lit things, but we're about to do litter things on this channel, okay? Give this video a big thumbs up and drop a comment down below. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So all of the items that I'm using in today's video will be linked down below, just because I want to focus on the chit chat aspect of this video. I want to focus on making sure that the conversation keeps going and I don't get distracted, so I could go ahead and spill all the tea that I have on these retail jobs that I've worked with you guys. So let's go ahead and get started. Before I start this video, I want to preface this video by saying there is absolutely 100% nothing wrong with working a retail job. The purpose of this chit chat story time is for me to share my experiences about the retail jobs that I work. So I did want to say that at the beginning, there's nothing wrong with working a retail job. I think I'm going to do like a bronzy makeup look. That's what I'm kind of going for today. So let's go ahead and get started. Why don't we? I went ahead and wrote down notes so I don't miss anything, because y'all know when I start chatting, I don't know how to stop. So I don't know about you guys, but I started working at a young age just because I grew up, my dad spoiled us, right? Like every weekend we used to go to Fordham Road to get a new pair of sneakers. My father spoiled the crap out of us, and at a certain age it got to a point where I wanted more things than he was able to provide to me. So I was like, I'm gonna go ahead and get me a job. So my first experience like working for myself was about the age of 14-15, and I did summer youth. So if you're from, I think it's a New York thing, but if you're from New York, you know summer youth, aka Summer Yummy. They provide summer jobs to, I think it's age 14 to 21, I want to say. They basically place you in local facilities, local organizations where you can work a job. The state, I believe, pays you, so there is no financial burden on the actual facility or the actual organization that you're working with. So a lot of the organizations were non-for-profit organizations. The two Summer Yummy jobs that I remember as clear as day was one at a nursing home near my house, and two at a non-for-profit organization in Harlem. And I live in the Bronx. I've lived in the Bronx my whole life. So y'all may be like, girl, how did you get placed in Harlem? I wanted to take the train so bad. So instead of being placed like in my local facility, because we used to have like local schools or local churches or local spots where you would sign up through. But instead of me doing anything in the Bronx, I was like, I'm going to go ahead and do Harlem because it's close to home. I could still take the train. I used to be so obsessed with wanting to take the train. I don't know why, because if you ask me to get on the train and now, I will be like, Kisa. So yeah, when I was doing summer youth, I felt like I was so grown. Like I used to get my little $120 check or whatever it was. It was really nothing, and I used to think that I was that girl, okay? Like you could not tell me nothing. You could not tell me that I was not giving rich bitch energy. You couldn't tell your girl nothing, okay? So when I was working at the nursing home, I felt like that was one of my first experiences realizing like how rude people are. Because before I work, like I would just be home during the summer or around my family, and my family is very nice, my family is very respectful, my family is very funny. So I always grew up with that energy. My friends the same way. So when I started working, especially when I was at that nursing home in Uptown, if you're from Uptown you probably know what nursing home I'm talking about. But girl, those workers were so rude. I'm like, you would think that people are working in a nursing home, they would be nice, like they chose this job because they actually enjoy like helping people who can't really help themselves. Girl, no, those people were rude AF. Like I'm just like, why did y'all choose to work here? But this is before I realized that people really work jobs that they don't love. They just do it just because they have to do it. I was so confused. I'm like, why are you guys being so mean to me? And then I realized, like, y'all not just mean to me, y'all mean to everybody. Like, damn. But as I grew older and as I like got more experiences with people outside of like my friends that I grew up with and my family, I'm like, yeah, some people are just rude AF. But yeah, so the nursing home, it was cool. I love my direct supervisor, but the ladies who worked in a nursing home as well as the men, like, they were just rude AF. So that did not make it enjoyable at all. And then when I was working in the non-for-profit in Harlem, my position was more of community outreach. So my job really circled around the matter of spreading the word of the organization throughout Harlem. So we used to go to like fairs. We used to be just on the streets handing out flyers and stuff. 1 year girl was hot AF. I'm like, why did I sign up for this? Community outreach just sounded so great. I did not know what it was at the time. But if you ask me to do that now, I would be like, girl, no. Because once again, people are rude AF. Like, you have a handful of people who are just like, oh, what's this? Like, tell me more about it. And then everybody else is just like, get out of my face. I'm trying to get to the train. I'm trying to get to the beauty supply store. I'm trying to go link up with my friends. And you're just in my way telling me about this organization that I don't know about. Like, what? Why are you here? So I would say that my summer youth experiences definitely helped me ramp up and realize that not everyone is as nice as I expected people to be. So that was summer yummy, that was summer youth. I'm sure I had another position, but those are the two that I really remembered. And then moving into retail, so I believe my first ever retail job was Century 21. In case you guys don't know, Century 21 is, I don't know if it's in other states too, but I know it's in New York and New Jersey. And they're closed now, but they're actually coming back. But it's basically a store that sells, a department store that sells designer items at a low price. So they sell like Gucci, Fendi, Louboutin, and then they also had the, I think it was LXR Couture or something like that, that was within Century 21. So they used to carry like vintage Louis bags, vintage Prada bags. But Century 21 was that girl. Like, I was so obsessed with Century 21. When my dad put me onto it, I'm like, this is where all my checks are going. And a couple of my checks went there, but then after I started working there, I'm just like, I have other things that I need to pay for. Like, so yeah, Century 21 was my first retail job, and I actually got that job through, I think it was called like the Bronx Workforce, I don't remember, but it was something that I applied for online, and they had like an open call. So I went to like this spot by 3rd Avenue on 49th Street. If you're familiar with the Bronx in New York, then you, yeah, I probably know what spot I'm talking about. But I went there, and basically it was like a 1 day interview thing where a whole bunch of people came in and they interviewed people, and you figured out if you got the job right on the spot. So I was like, let me go ahead and do this. I'm looking for a job. And it was in the city, which is where I went to school. So I went to the high school of fashion industry. So it was perfect. I'm like, as soon as I get off of school, I can go there. So I ended up getting the job at that like day fair situation. And I got the job for the Century 21 that was opening in Lincoln Square. But since it wasn't open yet and they wanted us to be trained, they sent us to the Century 21 in Regal Park. So I used to have to go to Queens for a while. And remember, I was just like, oh, it's in the city. The spot I'm interviewing for is in the city. I go to school in the city. It's going to be perfect. I was not anticipating a commute to Queens. And then I was living in the Bronx. So after school, I used to have to go from Manhattan to Regal Park, Queens, which is like, it's not deep into Queens, but it's also not like a Long Island city. It's not in Astoria. So I used to have to take the train from Manhattan to Regal Park. And then after work, I would have to take the train from Regal Park to the Bronx. So it was a heftier commute than I was expecting. But at the same time, I'm like, I'm gonna be in Manhattan soon, because we had to train in Regal Park for maybe, I don't remember how many months, but we were there for a couple of months. And then once the Lincoln Square location opened, then we were able to work from there. It was a good experience because it really showed me like that I'm not built for a heavy commute. And that's something that I feel like I rather had learned early in my working life than later on. So yeah, Century 21 was interesting. It was way stricter than I expected it to be. I had a very close friend who ended up, I don't know if she started working there before me or after me, but my friend Christina, if you're watching this, then hey girl, hey. We still friends to this day, but we used to be in Century 21 turning S-H-I-T-T-F up, okay? But yeah, so Century 21 was cool. The discount wasn't anything crazy. I don't remember what the discount was, but I know it wasn't anything crazy because I didn't really buy too many things on my employee discount. But it was just nice, like, just seeing what was new in store before people knew. And I used to tell my friends, like, girl, come to Century 21. They got these new Fendi hats and scarves. I remember that was my favorite thing that I bought off of my discount. And I actually lost one of the gloves, and I was so stressed because the thing with Century 21 is that they usually get, like, hand-me-down items from a brand. So if they have, like, a Fendi hat and glove set, it's not like you could go on Fendi and buy it. It's like from a past season. So I was dumb tight when I lost that. But yeah, so Century 21 was cool. It was okay. But as I was working there, I was like, this is not making me enough money. I need more money. Like, it's not able to buy me the amount of sneakers and clothes that I want right now. So I need more money. So while I was working at Century 21, I also got a job at Abercrombie and Fitch in Westchester. So where I live in the Bronx is close to Westchester. I live like borderline the Bronx and Mount Vernon. So I was like, if I work at Abercrombie, it was Abercrombie Kids in Westchester, like for me to get home isn't that bad of a commute, because from the mall to my house is maybe like a 15-ish minute drive. But also I wasn't driving, I was taking the train. So that's how I was thinking about it, but that's not how I should have been thinking about it, because I'm like, girl, it's a 15 minute drive, but who's driving you? But my dad used to work at this spot close to the mall, so I would like go to his job sometimes after work. But it was just a lot, because after work, you know, you just want to come home and sleep. So I used to have to like wait for him to get off of work sometimes, and he wouldn't get off until late. So I would just stay there, like, you know, doing my homework or just finding ways to stay entertained. I used to help him at work as well, but it was a cool job. Like, it was just like, ooh, Abercrombie at the time. But girl, when I was working there, I'm like, everything that glitters is not gold, okay? Like, I felt like that whole company was just racist as fuck. I'm gonna be completely honest. They used to give us like strict dress codes, and thinking back about it now, that's one of the main reasons why I kind of like kept my hair straight and kept straightening my hair when I was in high school, because I'm like, I have to fit this look and this aesthetic that they wanted us to look like, you know what I'm saying? So they used to be like, oh, like, you know, straight hair, curly hair, or whatever. And at that time, my hair, I didn't know how to make my hair curl. Like, my hair just did whatever it did, like, you know, little poof poof, little afro. So I used to get washed and sets every week, and that's how your girl got heat damage. So I'm using this new foundation today, by the way, the NARS Soft Matte Complete Foundation. This is my first time using it, and the reason I'm using it today is because I have an appointment with my esthetician on Monday. So if anything goes wrong, then hopefully she can fix me up, even though I have to go out this weekend. But yeah, I know what I'm saying. So yeah, I did not enjoy working at Abercrombie. The only thing was that they always needed people. So every time my shift was over, they would be like, oh, can you stay like an extra hour, can you stay an extra 2 hours? People used to love calling out last minute. So as soon as I'm about to clock out, people used to be like, oh, can you stay an extra hour? Can you stay until close? And to me, like, I was more focused on the money rather than like my peace of mind, or rather than me having, you know, time to myself when I'm not working. So it didn't really bother me that they asked me to stay extra at the time. Now that I'm thinking back about it, I'm like, girl, you should have went home. Like, you were only scheduled for 4 hours. And also, since I was a minor, I couldn't work over a certain amount of hours, so that used to be a thing too. So it just used to be a lot of like shuffling of the schedule. And now that I'm thinking about it, since I like honor my peace of mind so much, I'm like, girl, you should have went home. Like, let them figure it out, let them call somebody else in. But at the time, I was just so focused on money. And even though I was working at Abercrombie and Kids, there was also a regular Abercrombie and a Hollister in the mall. I don't know if both of them are still there. I saw the Abercrombie Kids when I went there the other day, and that's one of the reasons why I did this video. I was just like, oh my god, I never told my YouTube channel about the retail jobs that I had. Because when I posted on Instagram, people used to be like, you really used to work there? You used to work there? And I'm like, yeah, I used to work there. I used to be running Abercrombie Kids, okay? I used to be in the front, like, hey, welcome to Abercrombie Kids, while they were playing Carly Rae Jensen. What's the song? And if you want me, then call me baby. Yo, that song used to live in my head rent free, okay? But yeah, so I was like, let me go ahead and do this video to share with my YouTube family the jobs that I worked before, you know, I started being a career woman and I started, you know, doing my little accounting thing. But yeah, so I worked at Abercrombie Kids maybe for like 2.5 years. And it wasn't the most glorious job. Like, people used to be like, oh my God, like, they gave us, I don't think they gave us free clothes. I think they gave us like a certain discount. Like, they would give us 50% off of like $200 worth of clothes or something, just so that we could get our uniform, because we used to have to change our uniforms every time they changed the items that were available in the store. So the discount wasn't anything too crazy. I didn't really wear the clothes on the regular because I was just so annoyed, like, I have to wear this every day to work, so something's gotta give. But one thing I really, really loved about working at Abercrombie Kids is the relationships that I built. Some of my closest friends that I have to this day I met when I was working at Abercrombie Kids. Mike, Jamal, Emmanuel, Dana, we all met when we were working at Abercrombie Kids. I am missing some people, so if you're watching this video and we work together at Abercrombie, just comment and let me know. But yeah, I really didn't like the logistics of the job, but I loved the people that I work with. And I don't even remember like why I stopped working there or what happened. I don't think it was anything crazy. Like, I didn't get fired or anything, but I don't remember how I stopped working there. But I think after I stopped working at Abercrombie Kids, I started working at Lady Foot Locker in Soho. And I had went in for an interview. I remember it was April, I think it was April 10th, 2010, I think, my 2009, I don't remember, but it was in April. I went in, I did an interview, and at the time the managers were Michael and Rochelle, and they were so cool. I'm like, oh my God, this is a perfect job. I love sneakers. It's right by my high school. Like, literally, I went to high school in Chelsea and Lady Foot Locker was in Soho. Little quick train ride once I got off of school, but the only thing was that going home, because I would have to work closing most times just because I was a student, so, you know, I would just come after school. So I used to have to stay until close, and that train ride used to be hell because y'all know I live in the Bronx. So it was like an hour and a half home on a train every night. And, you know, as a young woman in New York City, that's not always the safest thing to be doing. But thank God nothing, you know, crazy ever happened to me, or I never experienced anything crazy while taking that train ride home. But I loved working at Lady Foot Locker. Michael and Rochelle were the best managers. The discount, it was popping. I used to be the plug in high school for sneakers. People used to be like, oh, can you get these sneakers for me? Can you get these releases for me? And at that time, like, sneaker releases actually sat in the store, so it was easier. And even though I was working at Lady Foot Locker, I was able to use my discount at regular Foot Locker, Champs, East Bay. So it wasn't like I was just restricted to whatever we had in the store. But yeah, I was the plug in high school, like the plug. And I will honestly say that Lady Foot Locker was one of my favorite retail experiences that I did work, just because my managers were cool. I learned so many things while working there, and also was commission based. So I feel like even though commission based jobs are usually like a competitive environment, like the people that I worked with, Alyssa, who else I worked with at Foot Locker, but we were all cool. It was never like, oh my God, like, some people were like, oh my God, that's my sale. Oh my God, I was helping her already, so, like, you know, that's my sale. But other people, we were mad cool. We used to be helping each other out. We used to be chilling in the store. We used to be chilling outside of work. So I would, Rosemary too. Rosemary was my manager at one point, and we're still cool. But Lady Foot Locker was one of my favorite jobs. It's an experience that I will forever be grateful for. And I would not take anything away from it. Of course, you know, every job has its bad, but I would say that out of them all, Lady Foot Locker was my favorite. Also, since I was working there when I was like finishing up high school and I went away to college, as you guys may or may not know, I went to Binghamton University. So I wasn't able to work in Soho as I'm away at college. So whenever I came home for like winter break or summer break, I was able to work in a store. But after a while, it got kind of complicated when they started like changing managers and changing rules, and like you had to work once every like 30 days or something. So after a while, I don't know if I got terminated or I ended up quitting, but after a while I was not working there anymore because they were changing the rules. And even though like my managers held it down for me, corporate, if you're watching this, then mind your business, but even though my managers did hold it down for me, it was like it got to a point where it was just out of their control, and they're just like, even though we've been holding it down, like there's nothing else we can do. So I just had to stop working there. But Lady Foot Locker, one of my favorite retail experiences ever. It was just so chill. I was able to like be myself at work. I was able to like learn so many different things about sneakers that still help me to this day. So I really love working at Lady Foot Locker. I think now they changed it to 602 in Soho, I'm not sure, but I went in there the other day and I did spill some girl that I used to work with in there. Once again, nothing wrong with still working retail, but she used to be popping the most crap. And not to say you still work in there, but she was like, oh, I'm about to get my degree, and once I get my degree, I'm out of here, dot 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 dot. Like, she just used to belittle so many people. And when I went in there, and obviously like I look different now, people didn't really recognize, well, she didn't recognize, I don't think she recognized me when I walked in the store, but if she did this, she just gotta mind her business and hold it down. But yeah, she used to be popping mad crap, like, oh, I'm in school, I'm about to get my degree, once I get my degree, I'm out of here, I'm not working here anymore. And then when I walked in there and saw her, I'm like, this girl that used to be popping so much crap years ago is still working here. Like, come on, sis. Another reason I was inspired to do this video, hold on, let me do my brows and then I'll be back. Yeah, I look a little crazy because I still have a tan. And but we're gonna fix this up a little bit, okay? So I did my brows off camera, and I'm just gonna go ahead and set the concealer that I use to carve out my brows. If anything, I'm gonna just go back in at the end to fix my brows. But my concealer also is drying very quickly with this foundation. I noticed when I use my Lancome or my Fenty Beauty hydrating foundation, my concealer never dries as fast. So I don't want to note that with me using the NARS, since this is my first time using it. I look crazy, crazy. But I'm gonna go in and bronze my face a little bit using my Fenty Beauty Sunstalker in Coco Naughty. This has been snatching your girl's face, okay? Snatch a boo hoo hoo. And I'm gonna go ahead and take my Morphe M518 brush, and I'm gonna take the same bronzer and just use that to deepen my crease. But what I was saying before I was doing my eyebrows is that another reason I was inspired to do this video, besides me being in the mall the other day, is the fact that I was in Forever 21 the other day, and I was at the register paying with Gabriel, who forgot to take my sensor off of my chain belt. And the cashier next to him must have been like a manager or like the head cashier. And you know how employees at most stores have to clock in at one of the registers? So like three people came to clock in, and it was like 12:55, and he was pressing them like, oh, what time are you scheduled for? And all three of them were like 1 o'clock, and he was like, oh, you guys have to wait until 1 o'clock to clock in. And I was looking at that and I'm like, this is one of the reasons I do not miss working retail, because people used to be going so hard for 5 minutes. I mean, like, I get it, it's a pandemic, and also Forever 21 and Cross County had closed and reopened, so maybe the coins is tight. But I'm like, 5 minutes, like five whole minutes, maybe it's just me. But I was annoyed for them, and I could see it in their face, like, okay, so you're doing too much. And he was doing too much in my opinion too, but I minded my business. I kept my mouth closed, and I watched them stand to the side of the register and wait for 1 o'clock to clock in. And I'm just like, go hards will always go hard, okay? That's one thing about them. If you're a go hard, you're gonna always go hard. And I'm like, in my head, I always used to think, like, is it coming directly out of your pocket? Or like, But whatever, so yeah. Now I'm gonna go in with a palette I have not touched in forever. It is the Lip Bar x Justine Sky palette. I was in love with this palette when it came out, but I just haven't reached for it in a while, but she coming out today. I have not brought her out in a minute, but she's coming out to play today. Okay, honey, oh my God, look at this shade. What happened here? This one. What happened here? Like what? Okay, so I'm gonna go in with the shade Bear With Me, which is this color. Shove it down my lid. I think I put both of them on my lid. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and deepen my crease a little bit more just because I want more dimension. Then I'm putting the two shades on my lid and I'm just gonna smoke that. Y'all know I am not the biggest eyeshadow girl, but I've been trying, and I also been trying new products, so y'all gotta give it to me. Y'all gotta give me my flowers in the comments. So I'm gonna take the shade Juju, which is more of a brown shade, and I'm gonna put that on my crease first. I'm just applying Juju to my lid. Juju is such a pretty color. And then I'm gonna go in with the shade Bear With Me and put that on top, but only in the middle. That is so pretty. And now I'm gonna go in and I'm going to take a little bit of the shade Bear With Me and use that as a highlight. So we gonna see. I don't know about this, I'm just trying something. Okay, super bronzy. I look like a glow queen, a glow goddess. Okay, how I'm looking. So now that everything is done, I'm gonna go in and set with my MAC Fix Plus. So while that's drying, I'm gonna go ahead and prep my lips. So I'm just gonna take some paper towel and wipe off my lip balm and any product that got on my lips. Hold me time. Don't let me rhyme. And I'm gonna go in with my MAC Chestnut Lip Liner and line my lips. And then I'm gonna take my Man Eater liquid lipstick from the Lip Bar and I'm just gonna apply a little bit of that to the middle. My One Size gel liner in Busty Brown to line my waterline. Benefit 24 Hour Brow Gel to set these brows. And my Roller Lash Mascara from Benefit. I feel like my lips are giving more of a purple than like a nudie brown. So let me see what I have here. I'm gonna try to put this Sephora liquid lipstick on top of it to see. How we looking? And I'm gonna put in these earrings I got from ASOS. To give us a look, what's a look without earrings? A look, okay? And I'm gonna take some NYX lip oil and put that on top. Just to add a calm gloss. I'm gonna do a half up, half down. And I'm using a scrunchie I got from an Amazon set. I'll link the whole set down below. Oh, honey, this is a look, okay? A look. So that's all I have for today's video. If you guys would like a full in-depth review on the NARS Soft Matte Foundation for acne prone skin, please comment and let me know, because I would definitely be willing to give that to you guys. I know I'm kind of late, but better late than never, right? So that's all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Comment down below and let me know what some of your retail jobs were, what your retail experiences were, what your retail experiences are if you're still working retail. Remember, I said there is nothing wrong with working retail still, sis. And let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know what you guys think of today's makeup look. I've been trying to do a little something once in a blue. So comment and let me know how did I do. Rhymes, bars on deck. And that's all I have for today's video. Before you guys head out, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel, give this video a big thumbs up, don't forget to drop that comment down below, and until my next video, I'll see you guys later.